talk a little gossip every now and then. Smell that ham cooking in the kitchen, a brand new sunrise in the sky. Sitting on a front porch, minding all your business. What a way to make the day go by.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Man, good morning to you. Welcome to the front porch. I just looking over Chamber of Commerce. We talked to some of the stuff in here. We'll talk to our buddy Woody Baird. He'll be out here. That's the mayor of Alexander City. He'll be out here at 7:30. Oh, welcome to the front porch. I already say that. Maybe I need to take another sip of coffee, but I'm going to need some help with y'all, from y'all. Here we go. Mighty fine. I think we're about to get over Emerson Ware on the phone. Our guest today, Commissioner John McKelvey, will be out here at 6:30. A lot of dirt we will show when he's out here. Jennifer Gregory, Tara Nelson be out here from Tallapoosa County. Master Garden Arbor Day tree giveaway that's coming up this weekend, matter of fact. And again, Woody Baird out here at 7:30. And a big old good Tuesday morning to you there, Emerson Ware.
Good morning, Mr. Kennedy.
How'd your Monday go?
I had a good Monday.
How's your Tuesday going to go?
It's going to go good because the Lord's going to be in.
There you go. I'm liking your attitude before you even get started with a thought for the day.
Yes, sir. It's going to go good. I'm just thankful, Kenny, that God has given us a brand new day.
You know what? That's a good way to just kind of sum it up, Reverend. I appreciate you being out here. Appreciate your friendship. I appreciate what you've done, you and your family have done over the years for this community. This is a great community to live in. You know what?
It is. I wouldn't want to live no other place.
Have you ever lived anywhere else? I don't know if we've ever talked about that.
Excuse me?
Have you ever lived anywhere else?
No place else other than when I was in the Army.
Where was that?
I took my basic training at Fort Benning, Georgia, mm-hmm. my AIT at Fort Lewis, Washington. I spent some time in Alaska.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Where in Alaska?
Anchorage.
I'll be darned. It's funny you mentioned that. I know our grandson will be in about a week, about a month from today, he and his wife will be headed to, he's with the Homeland Security. They'll be headed to Alaska for about 3 years. A place right outside of Alaska, I believe they'll be living. Eagle Pass, does that name sound familiar?
No, it doesn't.
But that's, Reverend, that's a long way away.
It's a long way, but beautiful country.
4,300 miles, to be exact.
Yes, sir. Old country.
Yeah, you're right. And I'm sure it's a lot of still old country there that people just have not even been in, probably.
Exactly.
Well, buddy, we're glad that you're with us. We're glad that you have served our country. Because let me tell you what, people say what they want to about the USA, but I say it's a great country to live in.
Again, I wouldn't want to stay or live any place else.
I'm with you, buddy. Well, buddy, you and I could go from one subject to another all day long, but we'll go ahead and turn it over to you for the thought for the day.
Amen. Thank you again for the invite.
Yes, sir.
I thought for this morning would be grace, grace-filled speech. Paul writes to the church at Ephesus in Ephesians chapter number 4 and verse 29 through 32. He says, don't let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouth, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. He talks about grace-filled speech. And Kenny, you know, words are powerful. And words can be hurtful. Words are so powerful that Jesus just sent his word into Lazarus' grave. And Lazarus got up from the dead. All he sent in there now, he didn't go in himself. All he sent in was his words. And words can either tear you down or they can build you up. Harsh remarks can cause a destructive chain of reaction, like the damage a lit match could do to a forest, like what's going on in Texas now. And there's this slogan, or this commercial that says, only you can prevent forest fires. Only I can prevent what comes out of my mouth. So in contrast, kind words, kind comments can feel like a summer rain that brings relief from the day's heat. And again, Kenny, words can hurt. Meaning that we should always be careful about what we say. Because once it goes out, we can't take it back. And Scripture clearly condemns, as I read in our hearing, Scripture clearly condemns gossip, deception, complaining, criticism, slander, angry outbursts, foul language, and vulgar joking. Sure, people will criticize you. If they did it to Jesus just for doing what he came to do, they're going to do it to us. And we started a club a few Sundays back, and we named it Mind Your Own Business Club. They got free admission. But on a serious note, anybody can tear down. But we need to build each other up. We need to be careful about our words. But yet now, our goal is not simply to avoid all bad speech. It is to speak truth in an uplifting and a powerful, positive way. After all, even correction can be delivered in a way that can be encouraging. Sometimes the problem is not so much of what we say, but how we say it, or how the other person receive what we say. And so many times our tone of voice and our body language convey much more than our words. So we need to be mindful and careful about what we say and how we say it. God bless you and God keep you is our prayer.
Amen.
Our thought for today.
You know, this happened yesterday. I went out to the gym at the hospital and I was leaving, and I ran into this lady I didn't know. And I said, "Hey, how are you doing?" "Fine." And she said, "And you?" I said, "Great." And then we exchanged smiles. And then as I was walking to my truck, I got to thinking, how many seconds did that take? Less than 5 seconds, probably, that short conversation. But you know what? I got a smile out of her, and I'm thinking, that was no time at all. So if we could just take 5 seconds a day and multiply it by how many folks we run into, you're still not talking about any time out of your life.
Exactly. And you know, words can be uplifting. Just a friendly handshake sometimes can be an encouraging gesture to someone.
A pat on the back to a child and say, you know, You did good today at school, didn't you?
Exactly.
You know, just you're right. The word encouragement is something we probably don't do enough. And again, words of encouragement, you're talking about seconds out of your life, and that's nothing to even squat. That's nothing. No time at all.
And Kenny, you know, encouragement is good therapy. It's therapeutic.
Yeah, and like Barney Fife says, it's therapeutic.
God bless you.
Thank you so much for those encouraging words today. And again, we hope you have a great day yourself, my friend.
You too.
Yes, sir. Will do.
Bye.
Yes, sir. I'm telling you, I enjoy carrying on the conversation with him. I enjoy carrying on the conversation with y'all, too. We got a lot to talk about today. But right now, we're going to talk about the weather. You can always talk about the weather. I don't care what's going on outside. It's going to be 60 degrees from now to the end of the show. I'll just go ahead and tell you that. The high today is going to be 64. Rain is starting moving in here before noon today, and then it's going to be with us for the rest of the day going into the night. 100% chance of rain. About an 80% chance of rain tonight. 57 for a low going into the rest of the week. Tomorrow, 70 and 50, no rain. 76 and 55 on Thursday, no rain. Dead Bob, here comes that rain again. 100% chance of rain Friday and Saturday. Low 70s, 57 Friday, but 44 on Saturday. And here comes that cool weather again. Sunday, 61. There's that 30 word again. 37 for your low when we get up Monday morning. There's your five-day forecast brought to you by Ellic City Marine. They know their time's coming. They know your time's coming to get that boat in the water, too, and they'll be ready. Are you? Ellic City Marine, Cherokee Road. Lake Martin, Dadeville Area Chamber of Commerce. A lot going on over in the Dadeville area. If you don't believe me, just ride over there. Go down 49, 34, or County Road 50, and you'll see a lot going on in Lake Martin, Dadeville Area Chamber of Commerce. They're right there in the mix of it. You can too. You can join today. Call 256-825-4019.
King Honda Car World kicks off 2024 with an unbeatable selection of new Hondas, available now for immediate delivery. Experience great products, an incredible selection, and fantastic prices on all of our new Honda inventory in stock. Our goal this month is to make it a month to remember by offering year-end deals at the start of the year. That way you get the best savings on any Honda in stock. Need to trade in your car? We're offering top dollar for quality trades, making your deal even better. Plus, this month only, enjoy free leather upgrades on all Honda Accord EX models. And we've got plenty in stock. Thank you for making 2023 our best year ever, and we're excited for an even better 2024.
Thank you all for a great 2023. I welcome the opportunity to meet you in person at a Honda store, where I know our staff will take great care of you. We hope to see you soon.
Visit our new facility at 2332 U.S. Highway 280 and start enjoying your new 2024 Honda this year.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
As your State Farm team, we will be there for you with the financial strength to deliver on our promises. Service that's a sure thing. You can think of us as your good neighbors who help protect what's important to you. We're here when you need us the most. You can call us 24/7 to get answers to your questions, file a claim, or see if we can find you more ways to save. We have many coverages and many discounts. We can help protect more areas of your life and find every discount you qualify for along the way. Please call us or visit 2048 Cherokee Road for coverage you can count on.
Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union, is looking for the next hometown hero. Hometown heroes can be first responders, public service workers, community leaders, pastors, community volunteers, or anyone who is making a difference in your hometown. Submit your nominations now online at myhscu.com. And if your nominee is selected, they will get a $100 Visa cash card and a certificate of appreciation from Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union, federally insured by the NCUA.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Hi, this is Brian Bice with Bice Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep, SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with service department second to none. Bice Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Bice Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
back out here. We got a lot going on today, and I know you do too, but I do what I can to get my part done, and y'all do what you can to get your part done. It'll be a busy day. I also say good morning to Kim Baker and Hanlon Boys. I went by yesterday afternoon, talked to those girls, and wow, just cut up and carried on. Always enjoy their shenanigans also, and the girls over at Meacham Marketing. I just love that name right there. Hollering at them over there. And of course, I had a good conversation with Tammy Montgomery out there with Arise. I'm talking about the Lake Martin Innovation Center. And a good conversation with Jacob Meacham. Buddy, thank you for taking your time to kind of go over some things. And in fact, that's where I picked up that old, in fact, I'm going to talk about it when Woody's out here, that old Chamber of Commerce, things that were going on back a few decades ago. But right now, let's talk about some things that's going on. Oh, and Sereth. I went by a Sun Diner yesterday afternoon, had a good conversation with my buddy Sereth. And buddy, hope you have a good day, my friend. I was just talking to our buddy John McKevy's already in the house, and we were just talking about I went out last night, and it was dark after WW's T-ball game. He don't like to call it T-ball. It's baseball at the college. And I was walking around, and then had to go pick up pizza at that pizza place on 280. And across the road on 280, 6:30 last night, the tractors were working with the lights on. See, those, John and I talked about when we had it, but when you got the equipment and you got the workers, you can move some dirt. And let me tell you what, there's some dirt being moved around here all over Tallapoosa County. And we're going to show you some more when John McKelvey gets out here. Hey, I got this note from LX City Parks and Rec. It said, it's come to our attention that people have been moving the barricades to where the coaches, handicapped parking lot at the baseball fields, and driving their cars on an acting work site. This is occurring especially on weekends. The parking lot is still an ongoing project and is not ready yet for a large number of cars parking in that area. So they're just asking you to do not move the barricades. That's why the barricades are there. So I'll just keep a friendly reminder on that. Here's a friendly reminder. You know, Kat, the executive chef, was out here on the porch yesterday from Doc's. That's a Doc's Cafeteria, Cafe at Russell Medical. Today, listen to this. This lineup: chicken pot pie and prime rib Tuesday, March the 5th. Bermuda blend vegetables. I've had that. That's good. Let's see what else we got. You got mashed potatoes, macaroni and cheese, cauliflower, salad bar. I believe she said they had 28 different fresh items, soft serve yogurt. I've not tried that yet, but I will. Chicken and wild rice soup. A good day for that. And special bar today is I think y'all at I like to call it Roman about bowels. Raymond Bowles. Well, you just asked for that special bar that's going on today at the cafeteria. Today also, this afternoon, Cancer Thrivers Support Group. We had George Miranda out here yesterday with the Cancer Center. This meeting now takes place at the Cancer Center right next to Russell Medical. Yes, we do have a Cancer Center right here on the Russell Medical campus, but that will be at 5 today. So take a loved one, take yourself, if you just want to hear what's going on in other people's lives. It's just a time to share your stories with them. Let's see what else we got going on around here. There's more stuff I don't want to talk about right there. Clyde Country, they got such stuff going on all the time. I won't go all into it. They got the first round is, I think they start out with about 100 and something. They're down to 80-something. So they'll have two more rounds this weekend at a little bit of, not a bit, Lake Martin, a bit at Martin's. So that's the old Colonel Tom's. Love that Colonel Tom's. They got the Rock South. That's coming up in July. Let's see something real local here. You got NASCAR going on right now, and you can hear it right here on Clyde's Country, 97.5. Citizens Public Safety Academy. Now, that starts tonight from 6 to 8. It's going to last for 10 weeks every Tuesday night. Classes begin tonight. Sign up, and it's free admission. Free admission. So put that on your things to do right there. Shane Harris will be out here next week, Tallapoosa County agent, and the Shane Harris with the Tallapoosa County Extension Office will teach it. They'll be teaching a basics of landscape design. This could be very good for you. It's going to be Friday and Saturday, the 22nd and 23rd. This will be very helpful for you, not just in helping you know how to do it, but how to do it right, and then that way you can save some money when you do it wrong, and just go there. Just put that on your things, dude. Oh, buddy, Dan Adams. Let's see if we can go with him. He and Suzanne Schultz will be out here next week to talk about his new album that's fixing to drop. I believe it's next week. Life and Depth. Love hearing them sing together. Excuse me just a second. Then we're going to talk about Wait Until Dark. Sure is good. Act Two presents Wait Until Dark. This is an old remake, an old play that they're putting on here this coming weekend. It was an old 60s movie, great movie. It's suspenseful. It's free. It's going to be Friday and Saturday night at 7 at the Benjamin Russell High School Auditorium. Also on Sunday afternoon, a matinee, 2 o'clock. It is free. And I know Rob Eiler brought this up the other day. Just because it's free doesn't mean it's not going to be put on well or a lot of preparation. They have a lot of great sponsors that pay into this to make sure that it's done, that they do put out quality plays. And this will be a quality play. A lot of work goes on behind the scene. All right, you got two more days before the steak dinner and auction. That's the Kiwanis Steak Dinner and Auction at Russell Marine Showroom on Highway 280. You know, they just had the chamber event out there last week. And let me tell you, they have come a long way making sure that is done right, fixed up nice, and it handles, I'm going to say they had, I'm not going to use it, 100, 200, 300 folks in there, but it was a lot of folks, and it's really well organized now. But you can still get a ticket, $50 donation. Remember that Kiwanis does a lot. They give back to the community, give back and give back. That's going to be Thursday. The doors open at 5:30, so you can get in touch with any Kiwanian. I think that's what Scott Blake called them, is Kiwanians. Also on Thursday night, if you're not going to be able to go to that, and you love bingo like so many folks do, it's going to be down to Elks Lodge. And remember, here again, the Elks gives back. All the proceeds from bingo go to the scholarship fund. So let me tell you what. You know what? I can't tell you right now because we got to take a commercial break. But we'll be right back with John McKelvey. Enjoy the ride. That's what you can do at downtown Alexander City at Welborn Museum. Now, this is part of Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County tourism. There are so much. You can go to this museum. You can go to the Horseshoe Bend National Park Museum. You can go to the Wind Creek State Park and just enjoy a day or an afternoon with your family. Heck, just by yourself. That's still part of Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County tourism.
Floyd's Feed and Seed covers both sides of the road in downtown Dable. Incredible selection of plants, stones, insecticides, and gift selection in the additional part. Original store has tack and boots for men, women, and children, gloves, hats, belts, and Carhartt clothing. Come on in and visit. Open Monday through Saturday for your convenience with a whole lot of service. Floyd's Feed and Seed, downtown, Dayville, Alabama.
We are Deborah Leaf Agency. We help people file Chapter 7 and Chapter 13 under the bankruptcy code.
This is Marcia Mason, your local Lake Martin Bankruptcy and Social Security Disability Attorney. Mason Law Firm is located at 217 Madison Street in Alexander City. Call 256-329-1313 to schedule your appointment today. All initial consultations are free and strictly confidential.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Trust Dixie Overhead Door to restore your garage door with a comprehensive tune-up. For a limited time, it's free for Dixie Cares Plan members and only $49.99 for others. Avoid a real-life nightmare and take care of the most important door in your home. Regular maintenance can reduce noises and potential breakdowns, extend the life of your opener, door, tracks, and springs, and quickly spruce up the space, especially important if it's turned into your new man cave.
Are you waking up in the morning with a sore jaw, headaches, maybe even ringing in your ears, all because you're grinding and clenching your teeth at night? That's exactly what was going on with me. That's when I found this, the Brux Night Guard. Now the Brux Night Guard redirects the bite force away from the back teeth, reducing jaw pain while still protecting the teeth. This unique design is what makes Brux Night Guard different from all other traditional grind guards. Go to BruxNightGuard.com and order yours today.
Farmers and Merchants Bank of Dadeville is building a foundation of strength and trust in the entire Lake Martin community. With our modern branch in Dadeville and caring, attentive staff, we've established Farmers and Merchants Bank as a reliable friend to your banking needs. Whether it's just a savings or checking account or any commercial, auto, or real estate loan, Farmers has local decision-making to build a relationship with you and your needs. Farmers and Merchants Community Bank. Strength. Service. Community. You don't have to ask who, what, or why. Who's Diner is the go-to place for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Conveniently located at the corner of Highway 22 and 280 in Alex City, Who's Diner offers the best meals and the best deals in town. Try our fresh, made-from-scratch pancakes, chicken salad, Philly cheesesteak, or the Who Burger. It doesn't get any better than Who? Who's Diner, of course, on the corner of Highway 22 and 280. Who's hungry?
Henderson Towing, Alexander City, 24-hour towing, jump starts, door unlocks, local and long-distance towing, heavy-duty towing. So let's get old Big Hoss to the rescue today. Here's that number. Now keep it handy. Henderson Towing, 256-392-4554, 256-392-4554. Henderson Towing, 24-hour towing, 256-392-4554.
We're about to come up on 6:30, and we're live and in color out here on the front porch with Commissioner John McKelvey. And he said he didn't care anything about hearing that weather forecast this morning, because that makes that dirt that you've been moving kind of hard to move.
Well, you know, when you're in that type of construction, it's either too hot or too dry or too wet. So,
you know, I was talking about the trucks or the big tractors with the lights on last night at 6:30 working. We're talking about having the right equipment, and you were telling me you've been working on it for 8 years, and you think you got the right equipment now.
I think we've got just about what we need for the operation that we do. We've got some new equipment that we're going to put online, but as quick as the road seasoning repairs start. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people don't understand that. I've heard a lot of comments on a lot of different stuff, but we're in a seasonal transition of road work.
Yeah.
And it's mandated, a lot of it, by DOT and laws and temperatures. But most of your road work here is from mid-April to mid-October, depending on the temperatures. So when you're dealing with petroleum products, it has a lot to do with the temperature, surface temperature of the ground. So so a lot of your off-season work is a lot different than road work. So we'll start middle of April, first of May, with some projects that we've got lined up to do with some equipment that's here. It arrived here in the last couple of weeks, and hopefully we'll put it in, put it to work.
John, I've seen over the years, too, with the shop out on Highway 22, how you built that shop up and had lean-tos or whatever. And I know we've talked about this before, but now we're having that right equipment to protect that equipment.
It is. I mean, and if you can't expect your employees to do a good job when they don't have equipment to do it with.
Yeah, or stay in the shop working on it all the time.
That's right, that's right. And there's a lot of difference in the private sector versus the governmental sector whenever you're dealing with employees, budgets, equipment. Private sector, you know, you can make money, you charge for this. We go in the year with a budget, we go in that year with employees, and, you know, we don't get any extra money for the projects that show up.
Right.
So if we get a hiccup in the middle of a project, it's going to cost us somewhere else down the road. So, and staying within budgets, it's pretty difficult to do. You're either going to cut a project, or you're going to cut equipment, or you're going to cut product. Private sector, you make it up on the next job. So it's a lot of different there.
You said something, I think you just explained something to a lot of folks out there just then with that statement. You know, I think right now y'all got six or seven employees, and you work 4 days a week.
Yes, sir.
Well, 10 hours.
The road and bridge department in the county, we've got, I think it's 25, 26 employees countywide.
Oh, okay.
We work 4 days a week, 10-hour shifts. And like I said, it's a governmental agency, and we offer sick leave, annual leave, holidays. You know, it's 13 paid holidays a year that we observe because we observe the state calendar, holiday calendar. You take those 13 days. You take 13 days of sick leave, 13 days of annual leave, and then you combine that with a four-day work week, and then you do your math. You're only working 6 months out of the year.
But that would also be good in trying to hire guys.
The 10-hour work shift 4 days a week is a recruitment tool that's there. They're doing a lot in the private sector also now. The benefits that the county's got versus the private sector's, it doesn't mean a whole lot to somebody that's 20 years old, but if you got 20 years in, that means a whole lot.
Yeah.
I mean, I was fortunate enough to get into the retirement system when I was 19. I retired from my first job when I was 49 with 30 years of service.
Golly. But for a 19-year-old, so, John, it's hard, to make
it. It is hard to make the ends meet with the cost of stuff now, getting into a job that offers benefits versus salary. And the county does pretty good if you've been there for 7 or 8 years, you can start seeing the difference in the salary.
Right.
But that's increased a lot in the last couple of years. We were fortunate enough last year to give a 15% pay raise.
Wow.
And it's come a long ways.
You know, I think about those guys and the experience. So many of those guys grew up on working on tractors, working on trucks. I mean, you know, so that
– yes.
That helps you out.
That makes a difference. And the program that they've got here in workforce development at CAC now with the kids with the equipment,
right.
It gives them some seat time on something just to see what it's like.
And that's something we're seeing more of. And Jeff Lynn has done a heck of a job. And others.
Yeah, you've got to have. Well, actually, one of my guys at the shop is one of the instructors there.
Wow.
It's coming a long ways. You know, at least they have that opportunity. If they don't give it to them, they may not have that opportunity to even get on a piece of equipment. So it's coming a long ways.
You know, you can teach, you know, they can look at a video and all that, but until they get in and on that tractor and get to moving it, that's when they find out, is this something for me?
It's seat time.
Can I do it?
I mean, it really is. I mean, and getting on a piece of equipment with in the work world or the workforce world, when you hire somebody and they have zero experience versus, I went through a course that I operated the skid steer, the backhoe, the excavator, it lets you know that they have some type of experience on that. So it's not coming in cold turkey.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think about, I was talking about the working excavator, or a skid steer, and or any type caterpillar, any type of equipment, and I think about they can. It blows my mind how they can look out there and y'all have that plan. This is what we got to do. This is what the school look. That's just that's a God thing. That's vision.
It takes some.
The eye.
Yeah. It takes an eye. It takes. And just like a project we're doing over in the Gap, whenever you're looking at a sheet there that's got the elevations on it, and you got a cut over here of 10 feet, and you got a fill over here of 13 feet, and it's over 10 acres, somebody's got to give you some straight line shots.
Well, what we're looking at right now, this is over in the Jackson Gap area on Highway 280, which if you're going toward Daywood, it's going to be on your left. How many acres is that? You've said before, is it 20?
We've got 99 acres there.
Oh, okay.
On both sides of 280.
Okay.
On north side and south side. This section right here is roughly 34 or so.
So what's in the future for this right here?
That's where we're going to put the covered riding arena.
Right.
And entertainment arena there for the county. We actually started some grade work on it last week, last Monday, and trying to get it to grade to where we can have it for the construction of the site.
Trying to get it to grade. What, is that just,
getting it level.
Okay.
So we started on it, and we're making some progress there. It'll take us, depending on the weather, I think we worked out there 2 days, and we've done a good bit.
I'm looking at what we're looking at right now, and depending on the weather, and we're looking at blue skies, in both days with this right here.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It makes a difference whenever it's that way. That right there is a practice facility that we started working on in Horseshoe Bend School for their track and field
Golly.
Team.
And that's just – and I know they appreciate that, too.
They do.
Horseshoe
they
Bend,
really
I mean,
do.
They've come a long way. But this slab right here, is this one in Hackneville?
That's in Hackneville. Okay. Their safe room that we've been working on. Jace Moran's done 99% of the work on it. We've done some site prep there for them. That's the storm shelter or safe room in Daviston. The one in Hackneville is going to look similar to that, if not identical to it, but it's similar to that.
Now, I'm going to say something you may not like what I'm going to say. That does not look safe to me.
Well,
tell me.
It is supposed to withstand a Category 5 hurricane.
Wow. What kind of material is that?
It's a steel. It's basically a big steel pipe.
Okay,
It's got
that looks like a tent to me.
It's got a restroom in it.
It's
got power. Okay. It's got a generator, handicap accessible.
Okay.
Concrete floor, and it's bolted to the floor.
Oh, now I see. Okay, thank you, Ryan. When I was looking at it, I'm thinking that just looks like a white tent of an event. I said, golly, a Category 5.
Yeah, it's pretty substantial when you get in it. It's
So is that about the same size in Hackneville?
It's going to be very similar to that, if not exactly the same size. Some of them are smaller, depending on the criteria that's in the grant that we've got. We've got another one. It's in the process. The wheels are still moving for one in Jackson's Gap. Started it about the same time as we did the one in Hackneville, and it slowed down some over there. But when you're dealing, with government funding and government agencies, the wheels of government are slow sometimes.
Andy Tucker was asking, what about our new track? What's he talking about? Walking track.
That's going to be the one I think he's probably referring to the one in New Site.
New Site, okay.
The
are town, you going to be walking on it, Andy? Come on.
Well, you never know what Andy Tucker's going to be doing, so.
You know, I think about when Jason Moran, our EMA director, when they put out that warning, we've got from a watch to a warning. They always, even the day or days before, they let us know where the safe rooms are. And we'll talk more about that when we come back. Well, Salvation Army, they're located on Highway 280 in Alexander City. You know, we're getting in that time of the year, March, April, when we have a lot of bad weather. And we never know what that bad weather is going to bring. But the Salvation Army is always prepared for it, whether it's helping out monetarily, it's helping out with clothes, but it's just being there. That name, the Salvation Army, has been around for many decades. We appreciate you at the Salvation Army, Highway 280, Alex City.
I'm Jimmy Goree with Goree's Furniture. We would like to invite you to come shop our huge selection of furniture. But if you don't have time, we have over 2,000 items you can have shipped directly to your home. Go to goreesfurniture.com, look for 48-hour quick ship. Shop, click, ship, it's just that easy. You can shop us here, or you can shop us online, only at Goree's Furniture.
Your expressway to saving.
At Russell Medical, we're proud of our exceptional nurses, like Nurse Brandy Worthy. Brandy represents the selfless, compassionate clinical leader patients expect and coworkers admire. Brandy was recently honored with the Nightingale Award for Nursing Excellence for her high standards, sound judgment, and caring manner. Her passion for her profession inspires us all.
Being a nurse is not just what you do, it's who you are. I'm proud to be a part of the nursing team at Russell Medical. We are the link between all hospital services, providing you with exceptional, personalized care.
In today's challenging world, our children need every advantage found in their education and spiritual formation. If you're looking for a school for your child or your grandchild where they will receive a great education, be in a small class, a safe place, a school where they're prayed for and with, a school where the Bible is integrated into the lessons, a school where they are encouraged and challenged not only in scholastics but also the Christian life, Veritas Lake Martin Christian School may be the place for you. Registration for the next school year has already begun with limited spaces. Call us at 256-537-5004.
Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. Same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
Serving East Central Alabama since 2005, we are Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical of Sylacauga. Coosa Valley Respiratory has medical equipment and supplies, including oxygen to home ventilation services. We carry a full line of bracing, power chairs, scooters, and more. And when you trust Coosa Valley Respiratory, you are dealing with local people that care about your well-being. Providing quality home care for our community, Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical, 201 West Fort William, Sylacauga. Give us a call at 256-245-1411.
The Alex City Parks and Rec Department serves the residents of Alexander City with quality facilities and programs designed to positively affect the lives of the citizens. From youth sports programs to adult activities and our senior center, the Alex City Parks and Rec offers services for all ages. The Cooper Rec Center, Lake Winds Golf Course, and the Senior Activity Center are just some of the great features the Alex City Parks and Rec Department provides for the people of Alex City. For more information on any of our programs, call 256-329-6736.
A1 Lock and Key Service. Owner Bernie Atkinson asked you to keep his number, 256-329-2539, on you at all times. Bernie has a complete locksmith service for auto, business, and residence. He is licensed, bonded, and insured with over 39 years' experience. Services include sales, installation, and a 24-hour emergency service. That's what service is all about. 256-329-2539.
Thank you.
Commissioner John McKelvey out here talking dirt, but it's dirt in a good way. A lot going on around here. So with April coming up, y'all are getting ready. I mean, you got all these other projects going on. How do you?
What I try to do is we have a road season, mm-hmm. then we have these other project seasons. Mm-hmm. You know, we try to do these other projects like this the stuff for the schools and special projects during those times when we're not able to get out and actually be working on actually the roads. Mm-hmm. You know, we do the potholes and driveway entrances and stuff that year round. Mm-hmm. But you know, when you actually start putting down road surface, it's got to be done within that window. So
right.
the other times is when we're doing these other projects and staying busy and trying to make a difference.
What I call the Ag Center, I'm not sure if that's the correct term or not, but over in the Jackson Gap area, is that a year-round project for y'all? Are y'all over there when you can, or how does that work?
Our goal right now is to get the site prep done and get it level to where
they can take over.
They can bid the building. Construction people can actually come in and put the building up. And it saves a tremendous amount of money to the county mm-hmm. because we're going to wind up moving about 100 to 110,000 yards of dirt over there.
Where do you take that?
We're moving it. It's a cut and fill project. You cut some here and take it over here and fill this low place in, balance mm-hmm. it out.
On that same location?
On that same project.
Okay.
On that same place.
Okay.
Yes. We've got enough room there to do that.
But here again, you got those guys that can see that.
That's right.
And y'all, I mean, that's the...
But, you know, if you bid that work out, yeah. if we didn't do it in-house, if we bid that out, anywhere from $3 to $5 a yard to move it.
Mm-hmm.
So you're looking at a $500,000 project.
Wow.
The labor cost to us is free,
mm-hmm.
you know, because we've got our labor's already paid for, it's already mm-hmm. budgeted, they got to do something.
Mm-hmm.
The only increase to us there would be the fuel and some equipment that we've rented. We've rented a large excavator over there to do some excavating with, but it's minimal compared to the overall cost of the project.
Right.
So,
golly, that's going to be such a our finished product time. When is that Ag Center going to be where we can have a horse show? Is that 2026, that far out? Or
I think we're within a year.
Really?
I mean, I can't say that for sure because there's other obstacles that, mm-hmm. that's got to be done. Other commissioners has got to say so in the things
right.
that how we – what's bid, what's there. But it's come a long ways. It's been 3 years now since we actually sat down and started talking about this mm-hmm. project.
So it's really come a long way in a short period of time.
It's come a long ways in the last year.
Yeah. You know, I think about let's just talk about the horse arena, where that's going to be, what that's going to bring in. You think about what Lake Martin, with all the fishing tournaments, when they the high school – the big tournaments that are coming in the next few weeks, the number of people that brings in. And it's going to be the same thing with that Ag Center.
I think so. I think you hit on something there, Kenny. I mean, it's kids having an opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, 5 years ago, 6 years ago, if you'd have told me that we were going to have scholarships going to school to bass fish, I would have told you were out of your mind.
And that's,
well, now it's the biggest thing to ever come through Tallapoosa County.
It's
in every school, and it's growing. Yep. You got participation in it all over the United States. I mean, it has become a national fad. So if you have the opportunity for kids, and there are kids here that go out of state
mm-hmm.
every weekend mm-hmm. riding horses, doing whatever,
mm-hmm.
I think you've given the opportunity that they will invest in it. And there's a lot of and people don't understand, the money that's involved in horses
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
is beyond recognition
yeah.
to me. I mean, because when you go out there and you buy a horse, somebody mm-hmm. told me the other day, if you're going to get into the horse show and business, you better have somebody that really likes it or somebody's got a lot of money.
Yeah. It's the same thing with
and the same
fishing.
Thing with fishing.
Yeah.
It's nothing to spend $75,000 on a boat.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah. Last weekend alone, there was 222 boats here. It's two per boat, and then the moms.
And then you got to have
everybody.
A captain. So
yeah, exactly.
three.
That's right.
To the
yeah,
boat.
Exactly right. Yeah. So and the number of people that brings in, and then you're talking about, but the dedication, the work ethic those horsemen and those fishermen have is unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
You see it. I've seen.
Oh yeah. I mean, those kids got to get up and go participate in riding horses. Mm-hmm. But on the flip side of that, this arena's not all about horses.
I know.
Mean, it's
all
about the venue of having special events there, and it's for the people of the county. I want it to be, and we want it to be on the commission side, is to be a place that you can have events.
Mm-hmm.
It's an arena. It's approximately going to sit 2,800 people.
Ooh, wow.
So you've got a venue for a concert. You've got a venue for the AWF cook-off, if you want to do it there.
Perfect.
It is an event center more than it is a horse arena. And I think the county is going to benefit from it. I don't see the downfall. Mm-hmm. I've said this in one of our meetings. Just for instance, if that building does not make it, some reason it just goes under. We can board that thing up and have a 60,000 square foot warehouse there to put on the market for an industrial site, and it will rent. I mean, it's an investment that we're going to get a return on them.
I know you're seeing that, but I guess what I'm seeing and hearing, the word ag, that goes into, it's not just about the cows and the horses and the pigs anymore.
No.
And here again, young people getting involved. I've had some of the 4-H'ers or the FFA out here. They amaze me at the direction. And when I say ag, I'm talking about Tallapoosa County, but right down the road, Auburn University.
Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, there's nothing that we do from the time we get up to we go to bed at night that does not include some type of agriculture.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
If you eat breakfast, lunch, or dinner, there's ag involved in it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you get a tractor and you go somewhere, there's if you hunt, if you plant food plots, there's agricultural
trees,
background, timber business, it's agricultural. So
chicken business is huge.
I mean, sooner or later, you're going to have the medical marijuana in the state.
Yeah.
Again, it's all agriculture-related stuff. And if you don't have the people coming up with education in it to do it or the desire to do it, somebody's going to be left behind.
Well, I just like the way that all the commissioners, I know you're good about coming out here, but we appreciate all the commissioners, what they do. And I don't think you get enough thank yous for what you do, and I know you're not looking for that, but y'all are rocking in Tallapoosa County right now.
The commissioners now, and there's five of us that have the heart and the interest of this county and the people of this county heart.
I know.
I've never seen a type of group that work together like we do to focus on a goal that benefits the entire county, not just their district, but the county. Matter of fact, that ag center down there is not my district. It's in Miss Imogene Thwaites' district. But it's a county project.
And we're all in this together. And the word tourism has not even been brought up. Huge part of tourism. John McKelvey, thank you for coming out here. Thank y'all for being with us. Now we're going to take a commercial break, and we'll be right back. Coon's Corner, Denny, there's a lot going on over right there right now. Conversation and good food. They'll also have some good lunch today. Chicken and rice and everything nice. Sweet potato casserole, Brussels sprouts, black-eyed peas, carrots, green bean casserole, English peas, cream corn, and all-American apple cobbler at Coon's Corner Deli today.
For over 80 years, the staff members of Radney and Langley Funeral Home have been friends in time of need, and we are dedicated to honoring, sharing, and preserving the amazing and inspirational stories of life.
You've got a friend.
And obituaries are brought to you by friends at Radney Funeral Home and Langley Funeral Home. Funeral service for Mrs. Jimmy Merle Giddens, 86, of Alexander City, will be tomorrow at 11 o'clock at Rocky Creek Baptist Church. Ms. Giddens will lie in state at the church from 10 until service time. Burial will follow in the Rocky Creek Baptist Church Cemetery. The family will receive friends tonight from 5 to 7 at Radney Funeral Home. Radney Funeral Home is in charge of that service. Funeral service for Miss Nanley K. Dean, 80 of Alexander City, will be tomorrow at 2 o'clock at the chapel of Radney Funeral Home. Burial will follow in the Alexander City Cemetery. The family will receive friends tomorrow from 12 to 2 at Radney Funeral Home. Radney Funeral Home is in charge of that service. And funeral service for Miss Lorinda McCoy, 61 of Kellerton, will be Saturday the 9th at 2 o'clock at the chapel of Radney Funeral Home. The family will see friends on Saturday from 1 to 2 at Radney Funeral Home. Radney Funeral Home is in charge of that service. And a memorial service for Mr. Danny Watley, 62 of Alexander City, will be Saturday, March 9th at 11:30 in the chapel of Radney Funeral Home. The family will see friends on Saturday from 9 to 11 at Radney Funeral Home. Radney Funeral Home is in charge of that service. To these families and to other families that have lost loved ones, my heart goes out to each and every one of you. To the men and women that are fighting for our freedom, God bless you. God bless the USA. And we will be right back.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau Tritons, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last, Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Arise is public transportation from downtown Alexander City. Now, from downtown Alexander City, they cover a 20-mile radius. Those vans are all over the place. When's the last time you went to see that friend? When's the last time you really needed to go to the doctor, but you didn't have a ride? Well, now you got one. It's Arise. Remember this. It's public transportation. Their number to call is 256-329-8444.
Have you been to Sure Shot Outdoors lately? Owner Scott Watson invites you to come in and take a peek at everything they have to offer. Not only do they carry the products you need, whether you're a beginner or an experienced shooter, their experienced staff offers both knowledge and the service you deserve. They also carry apparel, grills, coolers, and much more. Come on in and browse Sure Shot Outdoors today, your one-stop shop for all things outdoors. Located on Highway 280 in Alex City.
Grace's Flowers in Alexander City on Hillaby Street has been making people happy for decades. Susie Kelly and her friendly staff continue that same great tradition. Grace's Flowers is a full-service florist for all occasions, funerals, weddings, and other special events. In addition to flowers, Grace's has a great gift selection as well. To send a smile or encouragement, call 234-4238 and Grace's Flowers will deliver. Grace's Flowers on Hillaby Street in Alexander City.
Jeremy Worthy with Worthy Plumbing and Construction is carrying on a great family tradition, proudly serving the Lake Martin area and doing new construction, plumbing repairs, remodels, and a whole lot more. So keep this number handy, 205-936-4705. That's Worthy Plumbing and Construction. Again, the number to call is 205-936-4705. That's Mr. Jeremy Worthy.
Announcing Lake Martin Medical Center's new address at 815 Lee Street. Dr. Basil Rafai offers services in primary care, provides bioidentical hormone pelleting, and specializes in treating leg sores in the Lake Martin and surrounding areas. Our med spa also offers IPLs, laser hair removal, and a variety of aesthetic products and procedures for your skin care needs. We're your one-stop shop to looking and feeling your best. Call 256-212-9300 to schedule your appointment. That's 256-212-9300.
With the new year ringing in, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is ready for your lawn and tractor needs with a great selection of new and used Mahindra tractors and implements or Spartan mowers. And we're not just selling, we're buying. We'll buy your used tractor, car, truck, boat, motorcycle, even if you're not buying from us. And we pay on the spot. Whatever your tractor or mower needs, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is doing business and paying on the spot. Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor, Highway 280 across from Home Depot.
Do we have a plan? I don't think so. I know what we're planning. Well, we're just going to talk to the girls. I'm going to let them tell you all about it. In fact, I'm going to let them both introduce themselves because you've been here before, young lady. I believe this is your first time. It Bless is. Your heart. Why did they do this to you?
I don't know. I think they don't like me.
Well, why don't you just introduce yourself then?
Well, I'm Tara Nelson, and I'm a master gardener.
A master gardener, Mr.
Jennifer Gregory, a master gardener, too.
Tell folks what a master gardener is. Just real, real, real green thumbs for both of y'all, or?
Yeah, we all think we all have the greens of green thumbs. Mm-hmm. But we take, about 9 weeks of classes and learning that. About various things. And just because another reason is because we have a joy of plants.
Mm-hmm. And Kathy Shaka, Morgan,
yes.
She was Shaka. Yeah. We just lost her, and she was big into this.
Oh, she was real big. Yeah. Matter of fact, we awarded and gave it to Ricky. She got an award for putting in so many hours of
very deserving.
Volunteering. Yes,
she was a hard worker.
Kathy was very good.
Yeah.
Yes, Kathy Morgan.
She came from a good family too, and mm-hmm. I just always saw the world. And she fought that old cancer to just mm-hmm. couldn't fight it any longer. But she loved being a part of this. And how can somebody be a part of Master Gardener?
You can join at this tree giveaway. We are going to have a Master Gardener booth, and we're going to be able to sign you up mm-hmm. to become an intern. Our classes won't start until next year. We've already got a class in progress right now. And classes won't start until next year. But we will have a sign-up list, and we will relay that to the Alabama Extension office.
So, Shane Harris are very yes. much involved, and Shane Harris will be a part of this. And we were looking, or y'all were looking at doing it Saturday, but things may change.
We're going to make a decision on Thursday on if we're going to call this for Sunday, March 10th.
Mm-hmm. I kind of like the Sunday thing. I mean, you know, it's free. They're going to come no matter what day you have it on.
Oh, it
we
is.
Hope so.
Yeah. And it is free.
Yeah. I'm looking at, y'all have to help me with some of these words, girls. You have red maple. I'm familiar with red maple, one of the prettiest trees around.
I'm going to show you what a red maple looks
okay.
like. I've got the literature.
Okay.
And we're going to give away about 224 of these.
Okay.
And what has been so nice about these trees, and then you can kind of read various bullet points.
Mm-hmm.
What's nice is the Alabama Power has granted us a donation to buy these trees.
Wow, thank you, Alabama Power.
Yes, yeah. We appreciate it.
Yes, we do.
And the Southern Wax Myrtle, is that like a crepe myrtle, or is that a type crepe myrtle?
Actually, no.
Really?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
It's an evergreen. and it's great for really windy areas. Mm-hmm. A lot of people use them for a screen or put them around their house, that sort of thing. So
let me just say something about what you're saying right now. Somebody like me that doesn't know anything about it, if y'all go to these classes and become a master gardener, you're going to know about what you just said, about the wind.
Yes.
About how close to put it to your house or how close not to put it to your house.
Well, that's what I was going to say about becoming a master gardener. You can have a black thumb and still become a master gardener, because that's what the whole point is to corrects the myths that you've learned from mm-hmm. your grandparents mm-hmm. and passed down. It actually gives you information that's from the Extension Service mm-hmm. that is accurate.
I mean, facts.
Right.
Show me the facts.
That's right. And you don't have to have a green thumb. Mm-hmm. You can come, you can learn, and you can become a green thumb. And it's continuous education.
You know, I was just telling a young man the other day, and I just learned this from Shane. He was talking about planting the box, the little garden in the 4x8
container.
And I said, well, before you do this, find out. I said, get that container and find out about your soil.
That's right.
And it, I think it costs about $10 to get that done.
That's right.
And that can save you a lot of time. It can save you a lot of effort.
Yes.
And get it, and just buy that sample of your dirt, see what you need in that dirt.
And we're going to have the little sample bags out there when we give the trees away.
Okay.
So you can pick up a bag mm-hmm. and fill it out and find out what your soil is. Because that's a big part of successful gardening, is knowing what your soil is.
Are y'all seeing more people, just simply because groceries are high, are you seeing more people, getting into gardening or not?
I think at COVID time, we really saw it go up. I can't
good.
Say
mm-hmm.
it's...
Hey, we had COVID, but good that happened.
Right.
Right.
It went up. But I'm not saying it's great now, but I think with us seeing the cost and the weather turning, mm-hmm. people are going to start playing. I think it's going to pick up this year because the costs are skyrocketing.
And I think about canning, and that's kind of a lost art, too.
Yes, it is. And we do have, sometimes there's a lot of information on the Extension Service
right.
yeah, site that tells yeah. about canning, mm-hmm. tells about different plants and things like that. So the Extension Service is a really good tool for people.
And Shane Harris and everybody that's a part
yes.
of it, they do an excellent job because their hearts.
Yes.
Their hearts are in it.
Absolutely.
They love
are, yes.
what they do. You know, I'm not a gardener. I finally just boiled it down. I put some pots out on my patio, and it's just gonna be all cayennes. That's all. But y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. There's nothing like walking out of your house for me to pick some hot peppers to go with my meal.
That's right.
It's just it's not a better feeling, or even to give some away.
Yes.
Give it away, or even have an herb garden.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
know, for
mm-hmm.
your herbs,
right.
and go
mm-hmm.
out and get your fresh herbs. It's just a joy.
And people.
And talking about pots and containers, we're having a drip irrigation class
yes.
On Monday, March or April 15th, that we're opening up to the it's Danny Carroll with the Extension mm-hmm. Office is offering mm-hmm. this class on drip irrigation.
Mm-hmm.
That's where you put a little drip into your pots
mm-hmm.
so you don't have to worry about them. It's on a timer, gets water.
Wow.
That's right.
It's really a great thing. So that's April 15th. It's a Monday. Location is to be determined yet. But watch our website,
mm-hmm.
our Tallapoosa County Master Gardener website. Please follow that. So we've got a lot of classes we're going to open up so people will know. But in your case, your pots, if you had a drip irrigation, you wouldn't have to worry about getting up at what hour to water so you can beat the heat.
And watering's everything. I mean, especially, and the more convenient it is, the better it is. I mean, some days, or sometimes we go weeks without
right.
having any rain, and you've gone to all this work to get it all. It's finally coming up.
Yes.
And the thing about it, even the little 4x8s, it's still, you still got to tend to them.
That's right.
Every day.
That's right.
We're not through talking. We'll be right back. Well, come on in and get the scoop today. I'm talking about Carlisle, downtown Alexander City. They got a different soup just for you today. But, you know, sandwiches, they have those each and every day. They even got a Sarah Tyree hot dog. You say, what is that? Well, you go, you get your regular hot dog, get it loaded up. Then they go put some pimento cheese on it and get you a bag of chip. I know it's not the healthiest thing in the world, but it's delicious. Try that at Carlisle, downtown Alexander City.
Inspired by the bold bison, Southern Union students blaze new trails every single day. They press forward knowing their SU education will lead them to success. Affordable, accessible, and locally unparalleled. Whether you're transitioning to a university or launching straight into a lucrative career, a degree from SUSEC can help you blaze your path. Three locations, dedicated faculty and staff, endless possibilities. It's all waiting for you at Southern Union. It's time to venture forward. Register today.
Blue Chair Bay Rum presents Kenny Chesney, Zach Brown Band,
and a little bit of chicken fry.
Suncoast Down 2024 Tour with Megan Maroney and Uncle Cracker. Saturday, May 18th at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. On sale now at Ticketmaster.com. Produced by Messina Touring Group and AEG Presents. All right.
For years, Tom Watley's been a name you can trust to represent you. And now you can depend on Tom Watley Law, LLC to handle all of your legal needs. Tom has over 20 years of practicing criminal defense, probate needs, and estate planning. Tom Watley Law supports the communities of Lee and Tallapoosa County and can handle all your legal needs or refer you to their network of specialty attorneys. When it counts, call Tom Watley Law, LLC at 334-559-3420 or online at tomwatleylaw.org. No representation is made, but the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Hillaby Towers is an affordable senior citizens community located in Alexander City on Highway 22 East. Spacious one bedrooms are available now. Great location, peaceful setting, comfortable living where pets are allowed and utilities are included. Call today to find out more information on Alexander City's best kept secret, 256-329-0552. That's Hillaby Towers in Alexander City.
Medicare for Veterans, MedicareSalute.com. Medicare for Veterans, helping to maximize your VA, CHAMP VA, and TRICARE benefits. Call 256-675-5315 today. Ask for Amber Walker. Ask about Medicare, life, health, dental, and final expenses. Do that today. Call 256-675-5315.
At Fire Truck Barbecue in Alexander City.
Ooh, just for a taste, just for a taste. And you know that we're the place. Yeah,
yeah. Hungry for real Southern barbecue at its best? Just one taste is all it takes at Fire Truck Barbecue. Choose from their famous slow-smoked beef brisket, pulled pork, St. Louis-style ribs, smoked chicken, and more, complete with your favorite homemade side dishes and their famous peach cobbler for dessert. That's Fire Truck Barbecue, 226 Jefferson Street in Alexander City, and follow us on Facebook.
$500 over invoice now at Tony Sarah Ford. Every new Ford on the lot, $500 over invoice when you trade in finance with Tony Sarah Ford. Plus 3.9% financing for 72 months. Save thousands on new F-150s and more. All backed by Sarah's lifetime warranty. No charge. Every new Ford, $500 over invoice at Tony Sarah Ford. In Sylacauga, TonySarahFord.com.
Matthew Reams, Circuit Clerk of Coosa County, here to serve Coosa County. I just read off his what's in front of me right now. But let me tell you something. Matthew Reams is a huge part of the Coosa County area. Has been with his family for many, many years. Of course, a huge part of Sardis Baptist Church. huge part of the community as far as Triple R Cafe, and he's asking for your vote today. The polls just opened at 7 o'clock. Vote for Matthew Rings, Circuit Clerk of Coosa County. In fact, I was supposed to already remind y'all to get out and vote. The polls open at 7. They'll be open to 7 today. It is your, I'm not talking about Matthew Rings right now. I'm talking about the other candidates to get out and vote today, because it's your privilege. You know, we've had men and women that died for our freedom to get out and vote. So get out and vote today. You got all day long to do that. The girls out here talking about Arbor Day celebration. When is Arbor Day? Is it in March or?
It is officially in March.
Okay. But this is just near and dear to my heart, because I guess I think about people that maybe have a little bit of land or even have a little bit of space, and I was thinking about somebody planting something in memory, or maybe you got your children or grandchildren you want to plant, but you get, there's going to be over 750 trees, two trees per family.
Yeah, but and we're saying that now, but if we've got extra trees, we'll be given them away.
Because if I'm not mistaken, last year y'all gave them away in a hurry, then you had some more.
Oh, yeah. We had bare roots. We had potted. Mm-hmm. It was a great turnout. You know, people were lining up at 7 a.m.
I know.
Kenny came.
Yeah.
You came.
Yeah.
Did you get any trees?
Oh, yeah, yeah. But a lot of folks, if they came any longer, I think they'll go do it from 9 to 11 or something like that. And well, 9:30 to 10, they were gone.
That's right.
Yes.
But they did have some more. It will be at the Riverbank and Trust. And instead of Saturday, like we're talking about, it could be Sunday.
And watch the Tallapoosa County Master Gardener Association website.
Okay.
We've posted in various locations on Facebook, so watch Facebook. And then we'll try to get over here and say delayed if somebody comes. But we had people last year lining up at 7 a.m. I'm not kidding.
It's free.
Hey, but we've got some good news this year.
Good.
Besides the trees on the list we're giving away, we're giving away a Southern Magnolias. And these are 3 to 5 foot trees.
Oh, really?
And it's a drawing. Mm-hmm. And you got to be present to win. And then we have offered to sell 30 of them.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of as support of various things. But we're going to sell 30 of them for $25 each.
Okay.
And if you've ever looked at Southern Magnolias on to purchase, they are like $40 to $70 to find a 3 by 5 foot.
You're talking about a great gift. I mean, I can't think of a better gift, because most ladies love a magnolia.
Oh, yes.
I mean, you know, especially around the holidays, using the leaves off that to decorate the mantles.
Perfect leaves, yes.
But here again, another reason to turn out. Probably Sunday. Would it be, if you do move it to Sunday, will it still be at 9, you think?
It'll still be at 9.
Okay.
Yeah.
But again, it's going to be at Riverbank and Trust. We talked about the Southern Wax Myrtle. How about the Bald Cypress?
We got the Bald Cypress.
Okay.
We've got 96 of them.
Oh, wow. I like that one. Got swampy.
And you've noticed when you see down in here, I love the root base. Mm-hmm. It's just gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. It is. It's a... And you don't see that many around here, or do you, on the lake?
I have. There's an area up by Kalijah
that
have the cedar, Bald Cypress.
Where our son lives on the lake, they have one. Great place to throw a lure, too.
I bet.
It really is. Japanese crepe myrtle.
On the Bald Cypress, just because it looks like it requires a wet site, that's not necessarily true.
Really?
It's also very tolerant of a dry site.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
See, I would never, I've always seen
it. It's tolerant. It's not ideal, but it's tolerant.
Okay. So. Nice. Just learned something. The Japanese crepe myrtle. That's one that's very, well, I'm telling you, what's everything that's blooming right now? The white.
Bradford pears.
Wow.
And serviceberry.
Okay. They're blooming like crazy.
And our red buds have just...
I know.
Red buds have just started. Yeah. I don't know if you've seen the beautiful red buds.
What is it about spring that when it seems like things start waking up overnight?
Renewal.
And it's just a... It just makes you feel good.
It does. And I don't know if you've noticed, but the buds on the pine trees are starting to turn yellow. So yeah, people, beware. It's coming. It's
the yellow,
here.
The yellow pines are upon us.
Yes.
Overcup oak. I want to see the overcup. Okay. Oh, yeah. I love one of my favorites.
Yeah. That's
in fact, that I didn't know what I was looking at, but that's one of my favorite oaks right there. Mm-hmm. Love
so
oak tree anyway.
Yes, on the overcup oak, the reason why it's called overcup oak is because the on the acorn,
mm-hmm.
the shell goes like two-thirds away around the acorn, the nut itself.
Yeah.
And the reason why it does that is so that in flood areas, it'll float.
I've like a bobber. Never...
Yes.
Wow.
It's very buoyant.
I've never known that.
Yeah.
See, if you haven't been watching Front or listening to Front Porches more, you want to learn that. Now you can go share that with somebody. I think I've always called it Sherman, but it's a, is that a Schumard?
Schumard.
Schumard. Mm-hmm. Schumard oak. Here again, another beautiful oak trees, and that's what the South is so well known for.
Yes.
Yeah. Did you have anything to share?
I do. That is in the red oak family.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also tolerant of dry sites.
Mm-hmm.
It likes more well-drained sites rather than wet. It doesn't really like its feet wet. So.
Let me ask you something. Are y'all good at recognizing trees?
I'm getting better.
Really? Mm-hmm. I wish I was. I love, you know, I pretty much know what a white oak is or a water oak or especially a water oak. But the red oak and the, I wish I, the hickory, I mean, you know, I wish I knew better pecan. I mean, I know what a pecan is, but other
right.
than, how do you, other than just looking and getting familiar, is there a trick?
Well, there's a website, there's a little app you can put there's an app that's called, I can't remember.
You're talking about where you can put your phone?
Yes, and you can take
a
picture
amazing?
Of the
it
leaves
wonderful.
And the bark, and it'll...
tell you what it is.
Yes, it will.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to app ourselves death. I'm
that's right.
That's true. Nuttall.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right? Nuttall oak.
Yep.
Okay. Here again, that's a big old acre.
Well, and see, you can tell by the bark. You can tell by the shapes.
Yep.
You know,
awesome.
You see by shapes. Every tree's got their own little identity. Leaf. Even it's an
I
oak.
See the Schumard oak is kind of more of a pear shape, and this is
and that's you know like, and I know this is not a good tree, but the Bradford pear, I can tell by the bark,
yes.
you
mm-hmm.
can tell by the shape,
mm-hmm.
and Bradford pears are very
they break easy.
They break easy, so I'm not encouraging them, but
no.
they are pretty when they bloom, but they sure do smell.
Thank y'all for coming out here. Thank y'all for what y'all do for so many. Here again, you can get involved. You can join up Tallapoosa County Master Garden
yes.
Association. But the Arbor Day celebration is going to go on probably this Sunday. We'll let you know. They'll let you know on their Facebook. Just go to Tallapoosa County Master Gardener Association. Correct?
That's right. Correct.
Thank
yes.
y'all for coming out here. Thank y'all
Thank you. Thank
for
you,
being
Kenny.
With us. Up next, Mayor of Alexander City. Cloud Nine. Amanda Sullivan, new owner there, she loves what she's doing. And folks, if you've not been in there recently, I want you to go in and meet Amanda. She's a young lady. She's has two children, a great husband. So she's a family person, but she's invested her time and money into this business that she's been there for 6 years. So she's not the new kid on the block. She's a new owner on the block. Go visit her today and buy something while you're there.
The Morris Haynes Law Firm focuses on representing those who have been injured or mistreated by the wrongful acts of others. We have offices in Ellic City and Birmingham, but we have been calling Ellic City home for over 30 years. If you find yourself in need of a lawyer, give us a call at Morris Haynes 256-329-2000. We would be honored to help you.
Lake Martin Mini Mall is geared up for spring with new inventory arriving daily. See our huge selection of big green eggs and accessories, along with our expanded lines of high-density daybreak outdoor furniture and complete solar lighting kits for home, patio, decks, and docks. Lake Martin Mini Mall is also excited to announce our local farmers and artisan market starting March 23rd, offering farm-fresh vegetables and foods. Shop Tuesday through Saturday and mark March 23rd on your calendar for our spring kickoff party.
Music Depot, located next to Depot Gun and Pond on Highway 280 in Alexander City, is stocked and ready for you to visit. Huge inventory of quality name drums, amps by Laney and Fender, electric and acoustic guitars, pianos, fiddles, every accessory you need for yourself or band. Before you shop out of town, shop Music Depot on Highway 280 in Alexander City. Call 256-234-6767.
At CNT Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Elk City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word AND.
At Beyond Home Care, we provide in-home care services to individuals needing assistance with activities in their daily lives. We work with each client to provide personalized home care and sitter services, whether it's assistance with bathing and personal care or an escort to a doctor's appointment. Each client receives the individual care they need with the dignity and respect they deserve. Give us a call today at 256-414-6090 or visit us online at beyondhomecareal.com.
Satterfield Outdoor Living is Lake Martin's trusted friend for your outdoor land and leisure needs. We're the region's authorized Skag mower dealer for residential and commercial lawns and offer all the small engine accessories you need. With top lines of Steel, Echo, Shindaiwa, Husqvarna, and Metabo products that can tame any landscape. Satterfield is also your grill headquarters with Big Green Egg Grill, and our pros service everything in-house and back up all sales. Get the Satterfield Outdoor Difference on Highway 280 right across from Tallapoosa Ford.
You've dreamed about the perfect house, a place to call your own, and a place to not only stretch out, but to grow. Auto Owners protects your house because to you, it's home. That's simple human sense.
Happy to help, man. I was just over there talking to myself anyway.
Uh, 60 degrees right now. Your high today is 64. 100% chance of rain coming in around noon. It's going to rain for a while, even into the night. 80% chance of rain, low of 57. Rest of the week's looking like this. 70 and 76 Wednesday and Thursday. Low 50s tomorrow night. Mid 50s Thursday night. Rain back in here Friday and Saturday. Low 70s. 57 for a low Friday. 44 for a low Saturday, and Sunday, 61 and 37. So looking like a wet weekend coming up. We'll keep you posted on that. Five-day forecast brought to you by
Top Gun Pest Control, Highway 280 in Alexander City.
I've been handed a couple of birthdays. April Turner, Weston Harry, happy birthday to both of y'all. Mayor Woody Baird out here. And we will tell you before we say anything, get out and vote today. It's your right to get out and vote.
Right.
Seven to seven.
It's a privilege to be able to do that. There's, you know, how many countries have I been in that worked in over the years with the military that don't get that right? Yeah. They don't have that privilege. So, you know, and here you are, you'd have that privilege, and it used to just gall my butt worse than anything in the world, working in the mill. Mm-hmm. And some of them ignorant rednecks out there, which I was one of, at least I voted, but you'd say something about voting. these guys are 40 years old, never voted a day in their life. There ain't no sense in voting. It don't matter.
The heck it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And a person lost by one vote.
Yeah, that's right.
So if you don't think your vote matters.
Yeah, that's right.
Dead blame right, it matters. But again, like you said, it's privilege and also our right. People just like Woody Baird that fought in different countries, in those countries that they couldn't go vote or they'd get shot.
Now look what's going on in Haiti right now.
Yeah.
Oh, my Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we went down and tried to help them people and fix it so they could have fair elections. And it's just, gosh, you know, it's a mess down there.
Let me take you back to the year 1969. I picked this up from the chamber yesterday. Just some things that were going on back then. Tom Radins and his legislative committee working on getting a new post office here. So we got a new post office. Gene Gwaltney, who was a Russell president one time, Public Health and Safety Committee worked on mosquito eradication program, and these things still going on, sewage development and things like that. Leon Cohen and his Transportation Committee is working on railway passenger service, still trying to improve conditions at the bus station. Mm. So some of those things are still going on today.
Right. Yeah, I mean, now, you were talking about that first one that you were talking about them new post office.
Yeah.
When was that new post office built? Now, think about 1969 when they were trying to start it and when it actually got built.
Was it the 80s? Really?
Yeah.
Really?
It's like everything else that in municipal government, government period. It ain't got to be municipal government. Yeah. The speed of if I've said this 100 times, the speed of bureaucracy sucks.
Slow.
It's slow. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's awful. I mean, trying to get things done. We've been trying to get this water line downtown. It's CBDG grant.
Mm-hmm.
You can get a CBDG grant every year, but you have to close one out before you can get another one. We've held on this. We've been trying to do this one for 3 years because the price kept jumping up, and we had to get more funds. So we found some ARC funds, and we had amended the budget last night, the city, for $338,000 to pay the matching amounts for the grants we got to do that. And we're supposed to go to bid here real soon on that and try to get that water line put in downtown.
And I guess the next big project that we'll all see, if you even go downtown Alexander City, is going to be the courthouse coming down
March 1st. May 1st, is supposed to start, you know, both those buildings May 1st.
I have, you know, we have heard maybe what will go in there. We're
shooting for some type of civic center or some type of facility, multi-use facility, that all the citizens can use, everybody. And it'll give us a focal point because right now there is no gap. You can't put, we have no place in LA City that you can put 200 people in a room and have a banquet or an event.
Well, I saw some pictures of it yesterday, and it's the first time all of a sudden that art center, it was more than just a place to have a play. It was
right.
Huge, but it was also with everything that could go in this, here again it's money, you're talking about millions of dollars, but everything that's going to go in there, we've been looking for something to pull people to downtown Alexander City.
Absolutely.
This could be it right here.
This could be it. This would be it.
Yeah, yeah.
If we could get that built there, and like I said, it's a multifunction functional facility.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the renditions we've seen, it's you've got three or four different venues in the building, the way you can use it. And if we do that and we have a group to run it like Oxford, we've patterned ourselves after Oxford or looked at Oxford as a pattern. Get the two arts groups here in LA City, Act Two and the Arts
City
Arts Group. Yep, get them to come together as one. Be the patron group that helps maintain it and support it.
Mm-hmm.
There's more people down in the lake looking for something to do than you know what to do with, and there's money down there.
Mm-hmm.
And we get that. We bring people in here at least once a week, maybe twice a week, to some type of event.
Mm-hmm.
When was the last time you saw Three Dog Night?
they were
in Oxford here a while back.
Yeah. Yeah. But these are the type of things.
Of course, I guarantee you, a bunch of people out there don't have a clue what we're talking about.
But a lot of them do. but I think about it. But after I saw that, all of a sudden, I didn't see just an art center for plays and that type thing. I saw something that's going to bring people to downtown Alexander City. These businesses
Reinvent downtown.
Yeah, exactly.
Reinvent right. it, and it'll take off.
Well, you know, and you bring up bringing folks in from the lake. This would finally be something that would bring people in from the lake, and that's what we're looking
for. I got to go to a mayor's design conference here a few weeks back. There are only five mayors invited. You have mm-hmm. to be invited to this thing. Mm-hmm. And one of the common threads through that was some of these other communities had the same situation we had with 280. They had a major highway that used to run through their town, and it got moved out. Mm-hmm. And once it got moved out, the downtown starts losing business, and it just starts dwindling.
Right.
And we all agreed. I mean, it's the same problem. So how do you redo that? And I was the only one that we've been looking at this, and one of the plans I put forward was a potential civic center arts building downtown. Mm-hmm. And everybody agreed, all these designers, developers, architects, and all, they said we agree that'll reinvent your downtown.
I don't do committees much anymore, but I'm on the Main Street now. And one thing I've started, I'm not hit all the businesses, but I started going from business to business, just asking what do y'all need, and almost every one of them are saying it's some more events. Mm-hmm. So then if you put this event center down there, all of a sudden they'll come. Yeah. And then that's a different ball game.
And you have to look. You know, I've been plagued. The people downtown have complained to us about doing more.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you've got two parks down there, mm-hmm. basically. And you can use them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have event spaces. Use those event spaces. Mm-hmm. You've got, I mean, there's all kind of things down there that you can develop on. You just have to have the initiative and motivation to push forward. One of the biggest things that I see and complaints I get from the citizens is they go downtown and everybody's closed.
Well, there's nothing.
Everybody works the same hours.
Mm-hmm.
When the citizens get off, you know, the stores need to be open. If mm-hmm. if they're not open, if they go home the same time citizens do, then you're never going to grow.
Especially Saturday afternoons.
Saturday afternoon.
Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like trying to figure out what's going to be the best for everybody, and that's what they're working on. So the downtown is doing well. Now, January business for just about everybody was terrible.
Yeah.
And now even for even y'all, I'm sure y'all get beat up because power bills have just – skyrocket.
Well, every year it's the same thing every year because it's the weather.
I know.
And then we, of course, you know, we have this increase on the sewer. We've been doing a 7% increase mm-hmm. for 5 years to try to get us where we can break even. Mm-hmm. We're still not breaking even.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something that's got to happen. The service has got to pay for itself. Of course, we're expanding services. And in a couple more years, we're going to have enough customers on to have it. It'll break even on its mm-hmm. own. And we won't ever have to do this increase again. But even with the increases, we're still in the median range of charges on sewer.
Right.
You know, and our other utilities are, you know, our electric is better than anybody. Look at the power company.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to power company customers. Last year, the power company went up in about 4 or 5 months, went up 22%.
Wow.
They did it like 3 or 4 different levels. Nobody noticed that until it hit cold weather, and all of a sudden.
We got more cold weather coming. But right now, we're going to take a break.
There we go.
Triple R Cafe. I didn't get a picture of this, but they're adding onion rings. Yeah, he said, well, they ain't had them. No, they've not had them, but they're adding onion rings. So they're always offering something that you've asked for. Let me tell you something. If you're looking for a real good meal, especially their award-winning fried chicken, try that today. Triple R Cafe, downtown Rockford, Alabama.
Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center provides optimum care for the whole person. Dr. Dimo Popov specializes in the prevention and diagnosis of high blood pressure, kidney disease, diabetes, and acute and chronic conditions. Our weight loss clinic offers lipo shots and a guide to healthy weight loss. Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center, where lifestyle changes are made.
Benton Clearing and Grading is Cody and LD Benton, and they got your job in sight. Moving dirt is a clean job to them. Clearing a lot for your home or business is what they do, and they do it right. Call LD or Cody today at 256-397-2531 or 397-2532 for a quote today. I promise you, they'll do the job right. That's Benton Clearing and Grading.
Are you behind on your mortgage? Is the bank threatening to take your home? Are you considering trying to get a loan modification on your own? Did you know that less than 5% of people who tried on their own actually got a modification? At the Mortgage Modification Helpline, we know the rules and regulations banks don't want you to know about, and we've helped thousands of people stay in their homes. So call the Mortgage Modification Helpline today.
Please call 800-398-9786.
With numerous industrial sites across the area, first-class workforce development initiatives, and a business-friendly climate, Tallapoosa and Coosa counties have just what your company needs to be successful. To find out more, visit lakemartineda.com or call 256-215-4404 to speak to Executive Director Denise Walls. Let us make it work for you. Call 256-215-4404.
I'm used to living alone, taking care of myself, Mr. Independent. But every now and then, I need a little help. My kids aren't close, and I want to stay in my own home. As close as family is such a godsend. Carrie Profession here to help me with all the little things, taking care of the house and myself, keeping me looking sharp, feeling sharp too.
Learn more at asclosesfamily.com.
They really are as close as family.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
The food at Oscar's Cafe makes your mouth water. At Oscar's, enjoy great-tasting catfish, or maybe you're just in the mood for one of Oscar's fresh salads. Even kids know the place for a fine meal is Oscar's with a great kids menu. Oscar's also has great-tasting burgers full of backyard flavor. So come on out to Oscar's Cafe for great food and homegrown hospitality. We're located on Highway 49 South in Dadeville, just before the Blue Creek Bridge. And remember, it's all fun and games till there's only one cheese ball left.
Out here on the porch right now. Come on back in here and join us. Woody Baird, Mayor of Alexander City, out here. We're talking about the city council meeting was last night.
Right.
But also, this coming Thursday, you already had one opportunity, a chance to put your input in the city's future. It's going to be 5:37 at City Hall Council Chambers, and it's open to the public.
Yeah, this is a public meeting. We invite any and all citizens that want to come, that want to have input on the comprehensive plan. We're putting together a comprehensive plan for the next 5 years. Mm-hmm. We intend to have this to be a working document that we can utilize to check ourselves, and we can go back and say, okay, we accomplished that. Mm-hmm. You know, now what's next? And so that we can use it as a roadmap into the future. We've got so much development going on.
Strategic plan.
Strategic plan. Thing? Yeah, strategic plan and comprehensive plan. Okay. They hand in hand, right. Same document. And we need overlays to kind of go ahead and pre-plan a lot of these areas around 280 and 63 mm-hmm. to have an idea so that when it comes, we don't have to start from scratch. Mm-hmm. And we can start allocating our funds, start looking for grants. You know, we've had a wonderful time the last 3 years getting grants. I mean, I know that the last time I checked, we had gotten over $11 million worth of grants. And it's just, wow. You know, they're out there. You mm-hmm. just have to find them and mm-hmm. be diligent mm-hmm. and be have the initiative to ask questions and make phone calls and send emails and talk to people and fill out paperwork.
Who does most of the city's grants? Do we have one person, several people?
We have two or three different. It's according to what area it's in.
Okay.
Amanda Thomas, the community development director, mm-hmm. she does a lot of that. And then we have a grant writer that we actually have on retainer to help us. And he helps us mostly get through the ADECA grants and all, because there's so many little nitpicky requirements that you have mm-hmm. to, boxes you have to check in there on those ADECA grants. Mm-hmm. Then he helps us, keeps us out of trouble. Mm-hmm. And then we've got with AMEA, our electric supplier, Sarah Byard, she's a grant writer that they have on retainer that can help us. We have East Alabama Regional Planning Commission. You know, they can help us.
Didn't know anybody was...
A lot of people out there, yeah.
Well, I just know, I guess I'll go back to the Randy Thomas days. I just realized how much millions of dollars he brought in here, and now you got all these other folks doing the same thing mm-hmm. to help the city out. Yeah. I mean, you know.
Well, it does, and we've got, you know, the airport. Look at all the money we've gotten in the airport and what that's done. And we're moving forward out there. We're supposed to start on that apron expansion out there.
1,000 feet.
Soon. Extension. Well, that's the extension. Now, this is the apron. The apron in front of the big hangar there, there's a big grass spot.
Right.
We want to turn that all into asphalt so that you can park airplanes out there and that they can turn around easier and there won't be as much congestion.
All right. So when you finish with that, will that be in the next few months?
Yeah, it'll start either this month or next month.
All right. So when you finish with that,
then we'll start looking at extension.
Okay. Will that be this year?
No.
Oh, okay.
It'd be 25.
Okay.
Be a 25 thing.
Okay.
Yeah, we usually think it's about one a year that we can. When they're just like with the lights, you know, we had to shut the runway down.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord. You just wouldn't believe. Fred Dobbs. You know Fred Dobbs.
Dude, how long was it shut down? Because I didn't realize.
It was about, I think, about 5 or 6 weeks.
Really?
Yeah.
Didn't know it was that long.
Yeah.
That's a long time to shut down an airport and a lot of people to let know.
Yeah. FFA. Well, you put out a notum out on the FAA, you know, through the FAA, and people know they can't land there.
Yeah.
But
wow.
And see, when we do that, I don't know on the extension if that's going to cause a problem or not, but the apron won't really be because it's off the main runway, so mm-hmm. the runway can still be active.
You know, I think about the hotels that are coming here in the future. Now, think about what that does for our ad valorem.
Yeah. It's lodging tax.
Lodging tax.
Yeah.
Lodging tax.
Yeah. The one next door is it started. They hit some rock and they've been blasting rock.
I thought I saw one of those machines.
Yep. Drill. And the rain right now is kind of slowing them down a little bit, but they're moving forward. And there's a potential that we may have one come to the gateway.
Right.
And that would be huge too, because we still have all these tournaments and bass tournaments coming in. And we don't have enough places for people to stay. All these places on the lake, these Airbnb and VRBO mm-hmm. on the lake. But, you know, and what we're trying to do now is figure out, you've got to identify those on the lake, those houses on the lake that are rental properties. And then they got to get a business license.
Mm-hmm.
And then we collect lodging tax mm-hmm. off of them. See, a lot of them are running under the radar right now.
Okay.
So, but we're going after them. The county's going to help us too.
I know I keep bringing this up on the 222 boats that were here last weekend and what that brings in.
Yeah.
Just with those 222 boats, you're talking about three people per boat.
Yeah.
And then you're talking about everybody that comes in.
Fuel.
Yeah, fuel.
Lickies and Chewies, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I just think about it. Then we got another. We got several more bigger tournaments than that. And then when you start housing those folks in those hotels, what that's going to do. Mm-hmm. That's we've never been able to do before.
No, and it's just like last 2 years we've had this girl softball tournament come here. Mm-hmm. 150 teams. We had people staying 70 miles away because that's close mm-hmm. as they can get a room.
But when we do get those up and running, what that's going to do to those people to stay here, and then as we get another one, what that does, and it also opens up more opportunities for more tournaments.
Yeah,
absolutely. Kinds, land and water.
Yeah, they stay here, mm-hmm. they eat here, mm-hmm. and they shop here. Mm-hmm.
Yep. And they love it here.
Yep.
And you never know, I know we've said this before, I'm going to say it again, you never know when that person is here visiting, they like what they see. They like... They have an industry themselves somewhere.
Yeah.
You never know what the, let's look at
how many people have come down here to live on the lake and then decided to bring their businesses here.
Mhm. Mhm. But we've got so much going on right now. But again, at the meeting 5:37 at City Hall Council Chambers, this is your opportunity. This is your opportunity to get out there and voice your opinion. Instead of getting on that dead blame Facebook and voicing it there, come to these meetings right here, and maybe you'll hear something you hear the truth about the matter.
Yeah, the bad, and I talk about the truth all the time because that what's happening in LA City out. Oh my God, I have never seen so many ignorant people before in my life. They don't have a clue, and all they got to do is I finally got a bait of it the other day. And on what they were talking about, and I said, "Look, just give me a call. Yep. I'll be happy to explain it to you, because y'all don't have a clue.
Policy.
You don't have a clue what you're talking about.
Open door policy, and you should. You owe it to yourself. You owe it to your family to find out these facts. We've got so many great things going on in our community. Is it a perfect community? Heck, no. It's not perfect. It won't ever be a perfect community. But we're working on it to be a better.
We're doing pretty good right now. I mean, as much development hall we got." Just look at the dirt being moved, and there's going to be more that's coming. I mean, there's just more stuff coming.
I was looking down on 280 where Coven Abbott is in that area, and that potential there.
Yeah, Alexander Smith.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He bought that property, and he went ahead and fixed the one on the Davil Road side and made it marketable. And now he's off on the other side on Coven Abbott, and he told me, he said, "Look, we got to clear it so people can see it, so they can think potential."
And sometimes we have to be patient about bringing something in.
We'll very right very back. Patient.
Yeah. What's Kerr Market located on Davil Road right here in Alexander City? You know the biscuits. You've had the big old biscuits and how delicious they are. Now for lunchtime, soup and sandwiches. Homemade soups. Homemade sandwiches from 10:30 to 2, Monday through Friday, at What's Kerr Market, Davil Road.
GlennSmith.com, the great shopping experience you'll get at our dealership. Online, GlennSmith.com. Brand new Chevrolets, brand new GMCs. GlennSmith.com. Compare pre-owned models side by side. GlennSmith.com. Get your best price every day and see everything we offer at your convenience 24/7. Glenn Smith Chevrolet GMC in Opelika, Alabama. Get ready to smile at GlennSmith.com.
Hi, my name is Mac Alexander. This is my wife, Carolyn Alexander. And the reason we love our church, it's a just awesome family of believers in Jesus Christ. And our church genuinely has a heart for souls and community.
And we love our Sunday school class. It's a wonderful group of people. And we pray for each other in the good times and in the hard times.
Carlisle Heating Air says it's tune-up time for your HVAC system. Having your unit tuned up increases energy efficiency and can reduce the wear and tear on your unit. Call Carlisle Heating Air Day at 256-234-0019 for a price. Serving the Lake Martin area, Alexander City, Dayville, Jackson Gap, and Goodwater. Don't get hot, be cool. Call Carlisle Heating and Air today at 256-234-0019. Don't get hot, be cool.
For those who missed Zaxby's Egg Rolls the first time, these hand-rolled bundles of deliciousness are back.
Just in time to take a sweet and spicy dip. Yes, you heard that right. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's. Egg rolls are back at Zaxby's. They're hand-rolled and come with a delicious sweet and spicy dipping sauce. But enough from me. Let the egg rolls do the talking. And there you have it. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
Wintertime in the South is mild compared to other parts of the country, but we still tend to be less active and spend time indoors. Show your heart some love this winter by getting it checked out at the UAB Heart and Vascular Clinic at Russell Medical. I'm Dr. Kevin Sublett, and our entire clinic is dedicated to keeping your heart healthy. We're right here in your own community and backed by the knowledge and expertise of UAB Medicine. Make an appointment today by calling 256-234-2644 or visit uabmedicine.org/heartrussell.
While in Dayville, Alabama, get off the roundabout and stop in Payne's Furniture. Donald Payne says right now the selection of couches with end tables is unbelievable. Comfortable bedding, rustic bedding, area rug selection like he's never had, beautiful dining tables, modern and rustic. Ask him about financing. Or if you want to call him at 256-825-7727. That's Payne's Furniture in downtown Dayville.
Tapley Appliance is now Presley Appliance and Furniture. It's all the same friendly staff. And Mike and Trevor Presley not only offer the best in appliances from Whirlpool, KitchenAid, and Maytag, but now we offer full lines of furniture from Ashley, as well as a great selection of outdoor furniture. Make sure to visit the Presley family at the all-new Presley Appliance and Furniture on Cherokee Road in Alex City. Same great service and appliances, now with a great selection of furniture for home and outdoor.
Let's wrap it up, Woody. We're talking about the bridge on
Airport Road. You know, you see a lot on Facebook. Everybody's complaining, raising Cain about it. Those guys are about 6 months ahead. What the hell's wrong with y'all?
Really? Wow.
You know, they have knocked that thing out.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm tickled to death. I mean, they're paving it right now. They're getting ready. And it has solved the water over 280 problem because they opened that culvert up.
Mm-hmm.
That big rain we had Sunday was a couple weeks ago. Didn't even check up.
Wow.
Didn't even back up. So that was a huge improvement.
6 months ahead. Boy, you don't hear that much, do you?
No, they had just knocked that thing out. Of course, in the critical time when they were forming and pouring, they never had any rain.
Okay,
timing. So they were able to.
Timing.
Yeah.
And is that a state job?
It is, an Aldot job.
Yeah, we appreciate that. But we appreciate y'all. Just sometimes you got to be patient.
Yeah.
And just find out the facts. You can do that between 5:30 and 7 this coming Thursday night at the municipal complex. It's open to the public. It's open to you.
Or give me a call.
Yeah.
Give me a call at the office. I'll be happy to sit down with you or talk to you on the phone, anything. I'll explain anything that's going on.
Thank you, Woody. Appreciate it. Hey, we'll be back out here live and in color in the morning. See you.